And then I'd have to get in touch with that boyfriend of yours and tell him that he couldn't bring your little girl in to see you.
No, please.
Visits are a privilege, not a right.
Don't do that, please, Miss Fergus.
It's up to you, Latham.
B. Smith is trying to set you up. She wants the other screws to think that you and Hannah are on together.
Bastard. Let me have a look. Can't see any marks. What's wrong?
I didn't do anything like that.
Well, that's something anyway. Why are you crying?
Oh, you wouldn't understand.
Try me. Oh, I see. What's the problem? Isn't it enough?
Oh, very funny.
I'm sorry, Susie, but it's not the end of the world. Besides, you need the money.
Just because I'm broke doesn't mean I have to get money the way you do.
Look, take a couple of these. Make you feel better.
I'm not taking drugs either.
They're not drugs, they're medicine. They're perfectly harmless. Take them all the time. Come on, you can't go on like this all day. That's right. What are you going to do with the money?
Oh, I don't know. Burn it.
Silly.
Look, why don't you take it? It's my share of the rent.
You keep it. Like I said, you need the money. Better find somewhere safe to stash it, though. For God's sake, don't let Des find out you got a tip.
A tip?
Oh, well, you know, Lindsay's mate. He mightn't understand. Come on, you're looking a bit groggy. Do you want to go and lie down? It's all right, hold on to me.
You know, why was so late for breakfast?
Well, I had to go to the loo, didn't I?
It's true, the stuff they give you in here gives me the trots.
Pull the other one, Chrissie.
Okay. If you've got a loo, I've been scrounging a few things together for you to take with you over the wall.
What kind of things?
You know, food and stuff.
Look, all I need is a rope. Now, are you sure you've planned it?
Of course.
Is it long enough?
Yeah, no worries. There's a bit of a drop, but you could do it with your eyes closed.
The whole thing sounds bloody dangerous to me.
Yeah, well, there's no other way, is there? You want to get out of here, don't you? Before this thing with Ferguson blows up in your face?
Yeah, I'm not going to kill myself trying.
Yeah, we've got no choice, have you?
The work bell's gone, Latham.
Yeah, I'll just...
Get out! Not you, madam. You've got some very pretty things. Very pretty.
Got some more gear for Hannah.
Good, what sort of gear?
Soap and stuff.
Oh, we needed some good booze.
The soap smells great. I wish I had some myself.
That's not the point, you twit. We need something that only a screw could bring in for Hannah. Hey, where is she? Chrissie, where's Hannah?
I asked you a question.
And I said, I don't know. She's probably still in the dorm.
What do you mean, still in her dorm?
I don't know. Ferguson was with her.
What? Well, get on with you, look.
What's up?
Quick. Get to Hannah's dorm.
Why?
Don't ask questions. Move! I should have known you couldn't be trusted. That bitch is probably making her move right now, right under our noses. If you've screwed this up for us, Chrissie, I swear I'll have your guts.
Hey, look.
Oh, what happened?
Nothing. She just went berserk and smashed everything up.
Everything?
Then she made me clean it up and throw it all out.
She didn't touch you.
No.
But we've got to give that stuff back, you
but
know.
Forget about the stuff. Did she say anything?
No, she stood there and watched me clean up the mess.
Must be given to her. Good. Right, well. Put on more pressure and force her hand. We?
Well, you mainly. We'll step up the gossip, get a whole lot of more stuff. But you've got to get onto her. You've got to give her more reason to be jealous.
You've got to be joking. She almost killed me just now.
Well, she didn't, though, did she?
No thanks to you lot.
That was a mistake, but it won't happen again because Chrissie won't let it happen again, will you, Chrissie?
What the hell's it got to do with me?
Everything. Because from now on, you're going to stick to Hannah like a leech. And if you slip up and muck this lot up, I swear it's you that's going to bleed, Chrissie. Understood?
G'day. Where's the virgin?
In the shower, and she's not a virgin anymore.
Yeah, I know. Len was very impressed. I think he wants more of the same.
Well, he's not likely to get it. Susie was not impressed.
No? I wouldn't have thought he was anything to complain about. Maybe I ought to give her a bit myself, see if she complains about that.
You've done enough already, thanks very much. Just lay off her, Des. She's a friend of mine.
Just thought I'd give her a barrier trial before she joins the stables.
Oh, you're sick.
Look who's talking. You're a mess. Wipe your nose, can't you?
Des, I don't feel very well.
Yeah, I can see that.
Got any dope?
No.
Can you get some, please?
Maybe.
When?
Soon.
How soon?
As soon as you get our little friend in there to roll over and play possum.
She won't do it, Des. She's not like that. Don't you understand?
Oh, I'm sure you could talk her around. Point out some of the advantages, so to speak.
What?
Like getting a regular supply.
She's not a user.
I mean you, sweetheart. You like your supply regular, don't you?
Yeah.
Be a pity if I had to cut it off.
You wouldn't do that, would you?
Of course not. Not if you do the right thing by me. Hi, Susie. How's tricks?
Hello.
How are you feeling? Not hungover?
No, I'm okay.
You look great.
Thanks.
Wet hair, eh? There's something really horny about wet hair, don't you reckon, Donna?
You all right, Donna?
Fine, thanks.
Well, I'll leave you to Sheila's. I'm off to the TAB. Be seeing you.
You might have asked.
What?
About the money.
What difference would it make?
Oh, Donna, how come Des doesn't mind what you do for a living?
Why should he, love? Everyone's doing it one way or another. All them actresses and models you read about. Half them toffee noses and tour act. They're all getting their living the same way as I am. Girls like me are just more honest about it. You gotta be realistic. I mean, last night wasn't so bad, was it?
No, not at the time, but I wouldn't.
You see, and you got more money last night than you'd make anywhere else in a week. A kid with your looks could be mad not to get in the game. Make a quid while you can's what I say.
Anybody home?
Yeah, I'm in here.
Susie! How are you, love?
Oh.
Nice to see you.
Hi, Jude. Well, how's things?
Oh, pretty good. You know we're getting on.
I've been meaning to come and see you sooner, but, oh, this is the first chance I've got.
Oh, well, it's nice to see you. How's the job at the boutique going? Oh, sorry, you want some lunch?
That sandwich looks good.
It is. I'll make you one.
Oh, no, I couldn't handle a whole one. I could just have a bit of yours.
I got a half a sandwich over here waiting for you.
Come on.
It's a biggie. Not very elegant.
Oh, but nice.
Yeah.
Does anyone else live here?
No. Place isn't ready for anyone to move in yet.
Oh, it doesn't look too bad.
Yeah, it's getting along, I guess.
Well, aren't you scared living here all by yourself?
Nah. I get lonely sometimes. I don't get scared.
I'd like to live here.
Well, you'd have a long way to go to work, wouldn't you?
Oh, that. I got fired. Well, how did you find out about it anyway?
Well, Mrs. Morris told me. What happened?
Oh, I don't know. I guess I wasn't good enough.
Hmm. Well, what are you going to do now?
I don't know. Look for a job again. Well, I thought maybe you could use a hand around here.
I sure could, honey, but I I couldn't pay you anything.
Oh, that's all right. I've got some money saved up, about $100. Well, we could use some of that to get the...
Just a minute. How did you save $100?
Well, I don't have many expenses, and I've been staying at a girlfriend's flat in Fitzroy Street.
Fitzroy Street? Who is this friend?
Well, she's not really a friend of mine. She's a friend of Jackie's.
Oh, I see. And, tell me something. Is this friend of Jackie's in the same profession?
Yes.
Yeah, I thought so.
Well, but she's been real nice to me. And she's a real nice person.
Oh, yeah, they're all nice when they start out. And then everything gets to them until finally you don't know whether they're nice or nasty anymore.
Well, that's not fair, Judy.
Listen, you haven't been...
I haven't done anything wrong, honest. I just don't want to stay there anymore. But I haven't got anywhere else I can stay.
Tell you what, you go home, you get all your things, and you come back here and stay with me, huh?
Well, thanks, Jude.
It's really good news, Judy. No, I'm working all afternoon, but I'll try and pop in later, okay? Bye. Susie Driscoll's been in touch with Judy, and she's going to move into the halfway house.
Well, is that wise?
There's going to be a few despots there once that gets underway.
Well, Judy seems to think it'll be a whole lot better than where she is at the moment.
Well, what's wrong with it?
She didn't say, but I gather it's not exactly the why.
Duncan Campbell to see Miss Latham.
Oh, yeah, that'll be fine. You'll have to sign in. I'll go and get Latham.
Elizabeth not with you today?
No, she has the sniffles. But I thought it'd come anyway. We don't want Chrissie worrying, do we?
Where is she?
I told you, I don't know, you bastard!
If she's run out on us...
She couldn't have. She left all the things here.
You better be right. You should have found out where she was going.
I didn't even know she was gone. I was asleep.
Did you have a chat to her like I told you?
Yeah.
And?
She won't be in it.
Ah, what a load of crap. She'll listen to you. You're a friend.
I tried, Des.
You're a bloody liar.
I told her it'd be a good life with easy money. I tried.
You tell her you need the cash. You took her in, you looked after her. Tell her you're in trouble now. She owes you.
Won't work.
It better work. For your sake. You see this?
Give it to me, please, Des.
No. No, Susie. No smack.
She's not going to screw her life up just because I tell her to.
She'll do it to help you.
Maybe.
You tell her you need the cash, in a hurry, because you're in lots of trouble, and if you don't get it, someone's going to beat you to a pulp.
She's not going to believe that.
Well, we'd better show her some evidence, hadn't we?
All you have to do is make a pass at her. We'll take care of the rest.
What if the cavalry doesn't arrive on time?
It will.
Yeah, Ferguson's going to have to send Chrissie off first.
And what if Chrissie doesn't get back to you? She didn't last time, did she?
Yeah, maybe you're right. You should play watchdog for a while.
Yeah.
Oh, I don't know. Chrissie is my cellmate. Anyone else would look suspicious.
Yeah,
well. There's an interesting little trio, Miss Sharp. Wonder what they're talking about. Perhaps it's about all the goodies that Simpson's been collecting lately. Searcher.
It's not mine. I've never seen it before in my life.
Take it to solitary, Miss Sharp. I'll deal with this lot.
On what charge?
Possession of contraband.
You put it there, you bitch.
And insubordination.
She set me up. You all saw her do it. You bitch, Ferguson. I'll get you for this.
Well, Smith, what do you think?
Got nothing to do with me.
Oh, I wouldn't say that. You see... You're next on the list.
She knows.
She didn't say.
She knows!
Sick be buggered. Now look, I know there's nothing wrong with her, so why haven't you brought her in?
Because we're paying you $2,000 to set up a job, not play with your damned kid. Now what have you got worked out?
See the roof? Rope's gonna come down just over the loading bay.
Are you sure the rope's long enough?
Of course I am. I've measured it from the inside wall, haven't I?
Okay. Make sure Hannah's on time. If we slip up tomorrow, we may never get another chance.
Look, don't worry. I want her out of here as much as you do, don't I?
Rach, you'll have to go now.
Oh, Mrs. Morris, please, just a bit longer. He's just filling me in about Elizabeth.
Sorry, you heard the bell. But there'll be other times, won't there, Mr. Campbell?
Certainly.
When are you going to bring her in, then?
That depends on you, Chrissie.
Donna! What happened?
I don't know.
Oh, God, who did this to you?
Oh, the guys who own this place. I owe them some rent money.
They beat you up because you couldn't pay the rent.
Yeah. It's a lot of money, Suze. I don't know what I'm going to do about it.
Look, we'll call the police.
Be stupid. You want to get me killed?
Well, we'll get out of here. I know somewhere where we can
Forget it, love. They'll find me and then they will kill me. These guys are real heavies. Look at my face, would you? I'm not gonna be able to work looking like this. Oh.
Don't worry. We'll think of something. Oh, don't worry.
Well, of course, Simpson denied all knowledge of the liquor, but it's obvious it came from the same source as the rest of the rubbish in her cell.
Hmm. Well, I'm sure that's what they'd all like us to believe. But whoever it is has made a big mistake.
Why?
Well, all that other stuff's easily accessible. It could have been bought or stolen from any one of the women. No, this is different.
Well, it could have been smuggled in. Smith could have arranged that quite easily.
No, Smith doesn't have a motive.
Well, one of the other women.
Mm. Or a man.
Oh, but the only man in here...
That's right. Well, let's face it. It'd be much easier for an officer to bring this in than anyone else.
You don't believe that?
No, I don't want to. It all fits. And if it is him, this time I'll nail him.
You reckon we should try the Dunnies?
Nah, she's bound to turn up sometime.
What are you doing here, Latham?
Oh, Miss Ferguson, you've got to help me, please. They're going to kill me if they find out.
Stop snivelling and talk sense. Who's going to kill you?
Well, the word is that you got Hannah put into solitary and, well, B thinks it's all my fault.
Well, so it is, in a way.
You haven't told them that I lagged on the setup, have you?
I don't have to explain my actions to anyone. Now get to the recreation room before I put you on report.
I can't. They're all waiting for me in there and they've already come looking for me.
Do as you're told and keep your mouth shut. I'll be right behind you. Unless, of course, you'd rather I just walk away and let them find you on your own.
I want a word with you. Grab her.
Ah! Come on! Doreen, get your...
I said I want a word with you.
What about?
Hannah's in the pound.
Yeah, I heard.
Ferguson says I'm next.
Oh?
Now, why would she say that, Chrissie?
Maybe she fancies you too.
Don't you be a smart ass.
Well, how would I know? She's heavy in everyone, isn't she?
Is that what she did to you? Heavy you?
What do you mean?
Or did she promise you something?
I don't know what you're talking about.
You've been seeing a lot of Libby lately.
Elizabeth, so what?
Cut the crap, Chrissie. We all know how Ferguson works. Now all I want to know is why did you do it? Is it because of Elizabeth?
I don't know what you're talking about.
You lie, Chrissie! You've ruined it for all of us, you stupid... What's going on here? Oh, I see. Piggy squeals, sows come running.
What did you say?
I didn't say a word, not a thing.
All right, Latham, get up. Get to your dorm. I'll speak to you later. As for you, Smith, you can do your explaining to the governor. I'm warning you.
G'day. Can I buy you a drink?
No, thanks.
Can we go back to your place then? I can pay. Please? Just for a minute. Look, I won't do anything. The maids will watch.
Well, not tonight. Maybe another time, all right?
What happened?
Too pricey.
Ah, no, you're not smooth enough. That's your trade.
I didn't think much of her anyway.
Oh, yeah, come on.
We wouldn't know what to do.
She's not going to come now. It's too late. Oh, I wonder if something happened to her.
Well, maybe she's just changed her mind.
Oh, she wouldn't do that. No way. She was really looking forward to coming. Very enthusiastic. Gave me all her money. Well, most of it anyway. I wonder where she got all that money.
This friend she's staying with is a friend of Jackie's, right?
That's what she said.
Well, if we could find Jackie, perhaps she could tell us where Susie is.
Yeah, if we can find her and if Jackie hasn't gone out of town.
Well, we know where to start looking, don't we?
We sure do.
Let's go then.
You know the guys that beat you up?
Yeah.
Well, how long did they give you to pay?
End of the month.
Good.
What's good about it? How am I going to earn $1,000 with my face looking like this?
Well, you know the money Lane gave me.
Yeah?
Well, is that sort of normal?
How do you mean normal?
Well, is that the sort of average amount you get for sleeping with a guy?
About normal? Why?
Well, Lynn wasn't so bad.
What are you trying to say, Suze?
Well, I could get the money for you.
You mean that?
Yeah, why not? I owe you.
Thanks, Suze.
Oh. Shh. Well, don't worry. It'll be all right. It's not that bad.
Okay. Shh.
Get that woman out of your mouth and you know where she's been!
Pub in this area too. How about you?
Well, I've been up and down the street a dozen times. Police even asked me for ID. I thought I was cruising for business.
God. Well, what do we do now?
Go home, I suppose. And hope she contacts you. There may be a simpler explanation.
All that about between you and Smith.
You know, B, always getting that up about nothing.
Listen, you stupid little bitch. You're not going to make a fool out of me again. Smith was about to bash hell out of you, so I don't want any of your lies. Of course, something is going on, and I do want to know exactly what it is.
If I tell you, can you get me a transfer out of here before B gets out?
I don't make deals.
Not like some.
What does that mean? Who's trying to make a deal with you? Is it one of the officers? Is that why Smith was so angry? Oh, come on, Latham. Okay, give me a good reason and I just might arrange a transfer for you. Just the name, I'll do the rest.
Yeah, after what happened last time, you've got to be joking.
Okay. You'll play it your way. Do remember, though, Smith is due out in a couple of days, and no one, not even your friend, can keep an eye on you all the time.
It's out of the frying pan into the fire, isn't it? And I'm the poor bloody slob stuck in the middle.
Yep.
Oh,
Good evening.
It's Judy Bryant here.
Oh, hello, Judy. How are you?
Well, thanks. Mrs. Morris said to ring you. It was about the funds.
Yes, I've just come from a meeting with Mr. Douglas. You'll be pleased to know that he's approved the plans we were discussing the other day.
Oh, that's great.
Yes. Now, if you could let us have a list of the items you need, quantities and so on, we could get things moving at this end.
Okay, well, I'll get on to it straight away.
Fine. Oh, by the way, Mrs. Morris said something about Susan Driscoll moving in with you.
Yeah, she was supposed to.
Well, has she changed her mind?
I don't exactly know.
Oh?
Well, look, she said she was going to move in, but she didn't turn up. I've got no way of contacting her.
I see.
Actually, I was wondering if you could help Mrs. Davidson.
In what way?
Well, I don't want the police to get involved or anything, but I'm really worried about her.
Well, do you think she's in some sort of trouble?
Well, I don't know what to think. I've rung all the hospitals. I mean, she hasn't had an accident or anything.
Well, I'll see what I can do, Judy, but it really is a very delicate situation. The girl is no longer on parole, and we really have no right to interfere. Yes, I do understand your concern. Well, I'll keep in touch. Goodbye. Yes, Mr. Faulkner.
You wanted to see me?
Oh, yes, yes, of course. I'd like you to do an inventory on the old storeroom. This is the original, but it hasn't been updated for some time. It occurred to me there might be some things there that we no longer need, which could be donated to the halfway house. I'm sure they'd be very pleased to receive anything of use.
Right.
Corby, you might have stacked the dirty dishes for me.
Wouldn't want to do you out of a job, you old bludger.
Tell Doreen to put it about. Fergo had Hannah locked up so she could have a go at her without anyone interfering.
Is that right?
Doesn't matter if it is or not. Tell them anyway. Oh, I haven't finished that bitch yet.
I don't know. I'm always picking up after other people. Just like Patty. Bert only puts out the rubbish bins, you know. God, poor little kid. She must be run off her feet.
Can you hear me?
Yeah.
How long are we going to be in here?
About 48 hours, I reckon.
What?
2 days. It could be worse.
Any closer, lady, and he'll have to marry me.
Oh, come on, it's all clear.
Me drivers. What the flaming hell?
G'day, Toots.
Miss Ferguson, lovely day, isn't it?
Get any sleep last night?
What's it to you?
Oh, nothing. I was just thinking you won't be getting much when B gets out.
Bitch, you did that on purpose.
What did you call me? Lizzie, what have you been doing?
Nothing, it's all right. I just saw Ferguson going into solitary and I reckon she's going to have a go at Hannah.
Oh, crikey, what are we going to do now?
Oh, I don't know, but we've got to do something real quick. Otherwise, B's going to be mad if we muck it up this time.
Listen, Powell's going to be in here in a minute to take us down to the loading bay. We'll drop it to her then, okay?
All right, ladies.
Mrs. Powell? Can I go to the loo, please?
No, trying to get out of work again, Latham.
No, honest, I've got a really bad stomachache.
Always were weak in the guts, Latham.
Burns. Okay, don't take all day. Come on, the rest of you, get these trolleys moving. The van's due any minute.
Hello?
scream.
You try that again and I'll see you're locked up in here for a week.
Hey, Hannah. Hannah, is that you?
Answer her.
Yeah, I stubbed my toe.
You woke me up.
I'm sorry.
That's better. If you did as you were told more often, you wouldn't be in this mess.
What do you want?
Just wanted to see if you were all right.
Well, I'm not, thanks to you.
I had to do it, Hannah.
Yeah, sure.
You've got to learn to trust me.
Are you crazy or something? I mean, you set me up to get me thrown in here and you asked me to trust you?
Look, I know what prison life is like. This is your first time. But I've been inside most of my life. Well, not as a prisoner, maybe, but it amounts to the same thing. The people on the outside hate the screws as much as they hate the inmates. Maybe more. We do their dirty work for them. And that's all they want to know about. So, I've learned to take what I can from this rotten, lousy job. And you'd do well to learn the same thing. Oh, throwing your lot in with B. Smith and that mob was a stupid thing to do. Even if you'd gotten away with it, what good would it have done you? You're a fool, Hannah. Do you think that Smith and those other women give a stuff about you? Did they come to your rescue yesterday in the laundry? No. I'm the only one who can take care of you. Because I care about you. I can make your life in here very comfortable. If only you cooperate.
Miss Ferguson, I don't want to be comfortable. I just want to get out of here. So if you help me get out, I'll do anything you want.
You're in here to stay, Simpson. And the sooner you realize that, the easier it'll be for both of us.
About?
Oh, nothing, Mrs. Powell.
You shouldn't even be down here, Birdsworth. You're not supposed to be lifting heavy things.
Oh, that's not heavy, Mrs. Powell. Besides, I have to do my exercises. The doc reckons it's good for me dicker.
Well, in that case, just get on with it and stop wasting everybody's time.
Go on. Well, then I saw it for myself. Hidden for the pound it was. No, are you sure? She can't hear us. Do you really reckon it was Hannah's screw?
That's the word, and she's probably having it right now.
All right. What's all of this about Hannah?
Hannah? Hannah who?
Hannah Simpson.
Oh, that Hannah. We was just saying...
Yeah, we were just saying how lonely she would be.
Locked up in the pound.
With nothing to do.
Just stare at the ceiling.
I see. Try and finish up here as soon as possible. And if those two don't stop chattering, put them on report.
Hello.
I've been wasting my time with you. You're just as stupid and stubborn as the rest of them. Well, madam, you're just going to have to learn the hard way.
You're all bluff. You wouldn't touch me. You're too afraid of getting caught.
I have no intentions of touching you. There are plenty of other ways. And believe me, I know all.
Help! Help! She's dragging me! Help! Get off me! Stop it!
Got the locket, though.
Please. You're playing right into their hands.
You better have a damn good explanation for this.
Hey, Hannah, are you all right? That bitch didn't get you, Judy.
Shut up, Smith. Can't you see that this is exactly the same as that business with Steve Faulkner? Simpson about the liquor we found on her. She must have heard you coming.
You obviously didn't.
But they're trying to set me up, Mrs. Powell, and they're using you to do it. Now, I'm warning you.
No, I'm warning you.
Look, what you do in your personal life, okay, that's your own affair. But if I ever catch you in a situation like this...
What the hell?
Look at it, I know. They usually only sound it if there's a riot or a fire or if someone's gone over the wall.
You mean someone's escaped?
Fuck it if I know. But geez, I wish they'd turn it off.
Yeah, it was the usual van and I lost him. That's right. Rego number IQI639. Well, can't have been more than 5 minutes ago.
Who sounded the alarm?
I did. The laundry van just crashed through the main gate. One of the women must be on board.
Oh, hell. Okay, check the laundry now. There was Birdsworth, Burns, Kennedy, Shepherd. Yep. They were in the loading bay.
Right.
What's the problem?
Well, we think one of the prisoners has escaped in the laundry van.
Have the police been informed?
They've got a description of the van, but we don't know who the woman is yet.
Oh, I'm just going to organise a roll call.
Well, who was on duty in the loading bay?
Myself, Baker.
What happened?
Oh, I don't know.
I don't think anyone inside the loading bay could have seen her. Whoever it was came down a rope from the roof.
You spotted the rope?
On the way back from the storeroom. I didn't see the van. It was gone.
Oh, it doesn't matter. You acted very quickly.
Yes, it's a pity you weren't there until earlier.
I'd have seen the whole thing.
Oh, well, it can't be helped. I'd better inform the department. Let me know as soon as you find out who's missing. Oh, Heather. Would you get this back to the kitchen? Explain what's happened and tell Mrs. O'Regan I'll get back to her later this afternoon.
Okay, come on, let's get on with it.
Hey, good work, huh?
Did you go?
Bloody close. Put the smash more out, right?
Yeah? Who fingered you?
Oh, no, I didn't stop to find out. Anyway, I made it one piece. About the pantry though, mate.
Jeez, mate. Campbell would bloody kill us if anything happened to her.
You make it all right? Are you all right, love?
Yeah, maybe she fell off, mate.
Oi! Come back here!
Get off me!
I like this, too.
You bastard! Let me alone!
One more and I'll break your right.
Mate!
Chrissie's jumped through.
No talking, Birdsworth.
Laundry van.
Lizzie?
Coming, Mr. Faulkner.
How do you know it's true anyway?
What?
Come on, Lizzie, I heard.
Heather told Mrs. O'Regan.
And Mrs. O'Regan told you, I suppose.
I've got ears.
Don't believe everything you hear.
G'day, love.
Listen, what's all that noise about? Has someone tried to escape or something?
Chrissie shot through with the laundry.
Lizzie!
Oh, I'm sorry, Mr. Faulkner. I can't help myself. You ought to do something.
No, I don't. You've done enough damage for one day.
Oh. Dirty, double-crossing bitch, I'll kill her. Hey, what's eating you? You can't blame her for trying. That was supposed to be me. What?
That escape was planned for me.
Well, how did Chrissie find out about it?
She knew all about it. She was acting as go-between and using Elizabeth for cover. Stupid bitch, they'll never let her get away with it.
Wouldn't worry about her if I were you.
It's not her I'm worried about, it's my mother.
Hey?
She'll lead those bastards straight to her. She thinks that's where the money's hidden.
And it's not.
No. They'll never believe her. They'll kick her to death before they believe her.
Bloody Chrissie. He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines. The sun and rain are prisoners too. When morning comes around. Last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known. Till I had to face the nightmare. Right.